This video is going to be a quick overview in how to install OpenCore Legacy Patcher in under 5 minutes.
The quick summary is this will let you run later versions of macOS on unsupported hardware. I plan to make a follow-up video, What is OpenCore, so I can explain the differences between OpenCore and OpenCore Legacy Patcher. Before you get started with OpenCore Legacy Patcher, first confirm if your Mac is supported. Link is in the description of this video, as are all the links I use. The Mac I'm using is a MacBook Air 2015, and everything is supported. Now that we're good to go, we will need a USB thumb drive before we get any further. It'll need to be at least 16 gigabytes. Plug it into your Mac, open up Disk Utility, and format it as FAT32. Fair warning, this will completely erase your thumb drive. Next step is to download OpenCore Legacy Patcher. We'll go to the GitHub page and download the latest release. Nab the OpenCore Patcher GUI app.
While recording this video, OpenCore Legacy Patcher hit a very important milestone with the release of 0.6. This is one a lot of people were waiting for, as it adds in a slew of older hardware support, including some older Wi-Fi chipsets, older GPUs, and even USB 1.1. It also adds officially now the classic Mac Pros, which are the 3.1 through 5.1s, the 2008s through 2012s.
Once it's done downloading it, you may need to double-click the zip file to decompress it. Launch OpenCore Legacy Patcher. We are here to create a macOS installer, so click Create macOS Installer. Next, click Download macOS Installer. Depending on when you're watching this in the future, these options may be a little different. I am going to select macOS 13.1 since my MacBook Air 2015 can run macOS 12.6 natively. Since the installers are 12 gigabytes, it will take some time to download. Now, it may forward you to the next step, but if it doesn't, just go back to Create macOS Installer and click Use Existing macOS Installer. This is the installer you just downloaded. OpenCore Legacy Patcher will install a bootable EFI partition onto this USB thumb drive and also create a USB installer. If it did forward you properly, you'll be at the Select macOS Installer screen. Select the relevant macOS, then at the Format USB screen, select your USB drive. This will take a while, especially depending on your Mac and USB thumb drive. Once it's finished, it should tell you that it's successfully created a macOS installer. Click Install OpenCore to Disk. Once it's done building OpenCore, click Install to Disk for the second time. If your USB thumb drive appears as blue, that means it's already installed on the disk. But I'll step through this as if it did not install. So click the disk, click Install OpenCore onto the disk again, and it should ask for your min password. And finally, it will ask you to reboot. Notice that it says you will need to reboot and hold the Option key and select OpenCore Boot EFI option. This is important. You can click the reboot button now or reboot later, but when you do, you'll need to hold down the Option key to bring up the boot picker. The option you'll want will have the OpenCore logo in the background. Now it will bring you to a second boot picker. What just happened is we now have booted into OpenCore and are looking at OpenCore's boot picker. At this point, OpenCore has loaded in all its magic hacks and workarounds so you can launch the installer. So let's do that. Select your USB thumb drive to launch the installer. From here, you'll step through the macOS installer as normal. During the macOS install process, your computer should reboot multiple times. If for some reason it reboots and takes you back to the beginning of the install process, you will need to reboot and hold down the Option key, then select OpenCore, then from that boot picker, select the incomplete version of macOS, which is going to be the hard drive and not the USB thumb drive. Once you're finally done installing, set up macOS. Once you're all finished, you'll need to run OpenCore Legacy Patcher one more time. Click Post-Install Root Patch and confirm that it has been installed. And that does it for installing OpenCore Legacy Patcher on your Mac. If you'd like to see a more in-depth video on how to install OpenCore Legacy Patcher, I installed it on my Mac Pro 2008, which takes a little more effort. In the description of this video, I linked a couple other people who are making way more OpenCore content on YouTube than I am. So check them out too.
Hopefully you found this video useful. Thanks for watching.